Growing up in my family, I was always told as a child that good things come in small packages because we were short, very small in stature. And so many of the big kids would pick on us because we were always smaller than the big kids. We were always a little slower than the fast kids. We were always smarter than them, but we were always smaller than them. Or so we told ourselves. I never really understood what that meant until I got to this gospel going into high school. When we hear una semilla de mostaza que cuando se siembra en la más pequeña de las semillas, pero una vez sembrada crece y se convierte en el mayor de los arbustos y echa ramas tan grandes, it began to make a little sense. Good things sometimes come in small packages. It's the same way with us in the faith. Many times we try to do too much. Many times I have mothers come to me and say, "Father, how can I force my husband to go to Mass? Father, how can I force my kids to go to Mass?" Esta pregunta es la pregunta incorrecta. Porque no podamos forzar nuestros esposos o esposas para atender misa o nuestros hijos para atender misa. Solo podamos invitar ellos para atender misa. Because I don't know about you, but for me, if someone tells me I have to do something, I'm like, yep, nope. Not doing that. And many times for men, somos machismos. No, no me gusta. Entonces no voy a hacer. Okay. Es mismo con nuestros niños también. Pero yo puedo recordar en mi familia las palabras de mi padre. Cuando fue joven, I went to college, and I failed out of college, dropped out of college. Didn't go to Mass when I was there, but I considered myself a Catholic. I just wasn't really practicing my faith. And so I moved back home. Well, Dad's rule was always, mi casa, mis reglas. Cada fin de semana, vamos a misa. Sí, pero padre, no me gusta misa. No me importa. Es mi casa. Es mi regla, vamos a misa. And so I went back to Mass, and obviously it worked out. But many times in our world today, I can't tell you how many parents come to me and say, "Father, my kids are so bored at church. All they do is fight when they're getting them there in the church, and I just leave them at home." Mi pregunta. ¿Por qué? ¿Hay otras obligaciones en su vida que sus niños necesitan y atendan? ¿Pero con la más importante cosa en esta vida, por vida eterna, tenemos demasiados excusos? If your kids said that they wanted to stay home from school, what would you say? No, you have to go to school. Oh, that's perfectly fine. You really don't need to learn anything at school. No, we wouldn't say that. If your husband said, "I'm going to work all day long, and then when I get home, I'm going to take my shoes off, kick my feet up, and you're going to take care of me," what would your response be? There's the couch. And yet, when it comes to our faith, we forget how important it is. Con familias en la iglesia, ¿cuál persona, la padre o la madre, tiene la más influencia en la familia para atender misa? ¿Madre? ¿Sí? No. Padre. Porque si padre atiendes misa, Normalmente la familia atiende misa, ¿verdad? Pero si madre atiende misa, madre atiende misa. Algunas veces los niños muy pequeños, algunas veces por fiestas especiales, es posible que su esposo pueda atender. Pero muchas veces la madre solo, ¿sí? ¿Por qué? Porque la comunidad de fe es diferente con los gringos y los hispanos. Para nosotros, gringos, fue muy importante para un matrimonio con una católica. ¿Por qué? No es porque ella necesita una relación con Dios. No. Es importante porque con gringos, la influencia en la relación con Dios es con la esposa. Por mucha gente, especialmente en nuestra misa a las 5 esta noche, I didn't ask the question, but I saw on the faces they were afraid I was going to ask the question. How many of you husbands, when you got married, were not Catholic? But today, you are. Because when I looked out, it's like there's a family over here, four ladies, all of them married non-Catholics. All four of their husbands today, Catholic. Looked over here, it's like, he wasn't Catholic, 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 he wasn't Catholic. Pero ahora, católicos. Pero en una familia de México, de Sudamérica, de países con español por la idioma, es diferente. Porque normalmente la fe de la madre es importante por la familia, pero con muchas parejas no es demasiado importante. Let me explain. If it were so important for the woman's faith, for her to have it and profess it, the husband, who in the sacrament of marriage is called to sacrifice, would follow his spouse to Mass every week. I'm not saying this for our community here, I'm saying this for the community in the United States and throughout the world. Many times, if the wife goes to Mass, the husband doesn't come with. And yet we celebrate this weekend Father's Day, which is such an important celebration. And yet many fathers only go to Mass on Father's Day because the mothers make them go to church. Maybe that's just in my family. But I see it a lot. Typically, our 5 o'clock Mass, we have maybe 115, 120 people. We had 180 people for Mass tonight. And a bunch of husbands that I have not seen in a long time were here for Mass tonight. I look out this evening. Bienvenidos, padres. Gusta verlo. Pero me gusta verlos también próximo fin de semana. Y la última fin de semana. ¿Por qué? Porque es su responsabilidad por la fe de su familia. Si tienes hijos y no tienes una relación con Dios, es obvio porque sus niños no gustan una relación con Dios también. One of the biggest complaints that I get as a parent, or from a parent for as a priest, is, Father, my kids don't want to go to Mass and my husband won't help me force them. I'm inspired by you mothers as we celebrate Father's Day. Hay un santa en nuestra iglesia,
no esta iglesia, pero la iglesia católica, San Mónica. Su esposo no fue católico. Su niño no fue católico. No fue religiosa. Después de más de 30 años de oración por su esposo y su niño, los dos they converted and became Catholic. ¿Sabes quién es el hijo de Santa Mónica? Sí. San Agustino, un obispo en la iglesia hace muchos años. But it was because of the faith of his mother that continued to pray. Didn't poke, didn't pull, but prayed for her husband and for her son, that not only did Augustine become a priest and a bishop, but he is a doctor of the church. Good things sometimes come in small packages. And the faith of our women many times helped the faith of our men because we struggle. Es difícil para vida en nuestro mundo, especialmente sin fe. Con nuestro mundo que no necesito ayudar, solo necesito más fuerza y más machismo. Es suficiente por todos. Pensamos esto, pero es incorrecto. La más importante cosa que necesitamos es el amor de Dios. Porque si no tenemos el amor de Dios, es imposible para tener amor con su esposa y por sus hijos y por alguna gente en nuestro mundo. Si no tenemos una buena relación con Dios, quien es amor, es muy fácil para tener relaciones con cosas malas. Dinero es el rey. No, Cristo es el rey. Pero por muchos de nosotros aquí en nuestro mundo, the almighty dollar es más importante que todas cosas. We'll make every excuse to work more and work more and work more and do more and do more and do more. And at the same time, every excuse to not be the leader of our family. Pero su responsabilidad como un padre es por la instrucción de fe con su familia. Solo esto. Sí, para ganar dinero por las cosas, sí. Pero su esposa puede ayudarte con esto en el mundo ahora. Tenemos mucho esperanza en la iglesia y en Cristo, que invitamos esto en nuestros corazones y en nuestras vidas. Pero necesitamos invitar y no olvidar el amor de Dios entre cada cosa. You know, not just in St. Monica, but I've seen it in my own family, that parents can make a big difference. I was talking about how my dad said, "My house, my rules, and you have to go to church, Danny." When his mother, my grandmother, moved in, my dad told my grandmother, "Mi casa, mis reglas, abuela. Vamos a atender misa." "No me gusta misa." "No me importa, abuela." "Vamos a atender misa porque mi casa, mis reglas." 5 años hace su murió, mi abuela se convirtió en la Iglesia Católica. Después de más que 50 años sin fe. Porque la semilla de fe de mi padre fue suficiente. My dad was a small person, 4'11½". But he was a giant in the faith. Y tenemos en nuestra iglesia aquí hombres con fe. Necesitamos más hombres de fe para vivir su fe. There's no reason to hide from your faith. No reason to.
I'm going
to
pardon the hospital.
No. Be bold. Be courageous, as we heard of in our second reading today. Oh, no, no. It's my wife's job to start prayer. No. Es su responsabilidad para empezar oración. Yes, for meals, but also any other time. It is your responsibility, men, to lead your family in the faith. Your wife is here to assist you in that. When was the last time that your wife told you that, Gonzo? He's like, nope, that's her responsibility. No. Somos padres por una razón. Porque tenemos un buen padre. Una padre perfecta. Por un modelo y para ayudarnos. Porque sus amigos afuera de la iglesia no entienden. Ah, fe, no necesito fe. Ah, misa, no necesito misa. Necesito mi trabajo. Necesito mi taza de alcohol. Mi cerveza. Mi telenovelas. Oh, that's normally the women, but yes. Guys like TV too, occasionally. I need these other things that don't really matter. I need more jewelry. I need a better car. No, you need to stop making excuses. I mentioned at the Mass at 5 o'clock that I was surprised that we had so many people here because it is a beautiful day outside. I was expecting it's Father's Day weekend. Everybody's going to be gone this weekend because the lake down the street looks gorgeous. And so I said to the parents there, thank you for making this an important thing for your children this weekend. For prioritizing it over the sports that's on TV, over the sports that you could be doing, over the relaxation that you could be doing, over the parties that you could be at, over the quinceañera parties you could be at. Because it seems like every weekend, that's the excuse. Oh, lo siento, padre. Fue un quince. ¿Dónde? No aquí. No en Clinton. ¿Dónde está la quinceañera? Oh, muy largo. Fue un fiesta, sí. Pero un bendición por un quinceañera no es muy frecuentemente ahora. Es muy similar de matrimonios ahora. Hay muchas fiestas, pero no aniversarios de boda. Porque una promesa de Dios es muy importante, es muy serio. Gustamos fe fácil, fe simple. No fe con responsabilidades. Pero no somos protestantes. Somos católicos. Tenemos responsabilidades para practicar nuestra fe. Para cambiar el mundo. Poco a poco. a poco. Hoy es la oportunidad para empezar esto. Una pequeña semilla de esta misa puede cambiar nuestro mundo if we allow it to. May we use this opportunity then to let God love us so that we can love each other and we can change the world.